Hey, it's me, Smile McGee, and today I'm taking you guys along with me for my 3-hour breast biopsy. I have been super nervous for this. As you guys know, I've had a sarcoma in the past, so anything tumor related scares the crap out of me, and I seem to have a talent for growing tumors. I have to get my breast checked about every 6 months because it's another place I'm very good at growing tumors, and these new tumors grew a little too fast. Also forgot to mention the margins of the tumor. So, sorry, my normal tumors are well circumscribed, which means the margins are like this. Totally round, totally normal. These new tumors, and part of the reason they wanted them kind of out of there is because they're lobulated. So it means they're like bloop, 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 kind of popcorn-y shaped. Doesn't always mean cancer, but it can not mean the greatest things. The type of tumors I get can come in different shape variations. So we're removing these tumors. So basically just avoiding any more evasive procedures. If they're benign, can get bigger, or if they are cancer, we find out while they're small. So we got to get these suckers out of here. The tech is super, super nice. I'm kind of worried about my blood levels with the new chemo pill, but I told her everything and she's really cool. So hopefully this isn't as bad as I think it's gonna be. And they're using a fancy boob vacuum, so I'll show it to you guys. This is the boob swiffer. And basically this guy, she said it has lidocaine going through it while they remove the tumors, so that's kind of nice. So you're just getting filled up with numbing fluid. I mean, if you have to get your boob brutalized, I guess that's the way to do it, right? It takes a little longer because I guess they're just trying to remove all of the tumors and make it so I don't have to go under for a surgery, because I guess these really need to be removed. Yeah, I'm still freaking out. We will see how this goes, and I will give you guys the full update once this sucker is done. So I am done with the biopsy, and it definitely was not as bad as I thought it was going to be. So I thought this was gonna be like 3 hours, like an hour per tumor, and I was freaking out, because that's basically like, when they explained it, that's what they told me. And I've had biopsies in the past, but they've been like, snap, like super easy. So an hour per tumor, that, oh my heck, that sounded so intimidating and I was so scared. But I got in there and the nurse slash tech was the funniest lady ever. She was telling me all of her dating stories from the past weekend, and we just kept on talking and talking, and I'm pretty sure we're best friends now. She made my day. Like, seriously, medical professionals, you do not know how much it means when you take the time to like remember your patients are human and talk with them and help them be less scared of like a really scary situation. Like, just feeling normal for a few seconds means everything. And then the radiologist came in and I asked him, I'm like, is this really gonna be 3 hours? And he busted up laughing. He's like, oh no, this is gonna be like an hour max. This is definitely not gonna be 3 hours. It was like, holla freaking yeah. It felt like they were gonna like remove it with like chopsticks or something if it's gonna be 3 hours. But I'm not really supposed to be sitting here. I forgot to mention the funniest part. So before they started the biopsy, all of a sudden that nurse I love and the surgeon start talking. She's like, this is Megan Yeager. She is 26 years old. Starts listing off my health history. And I'm just like, who in the heck are they talking to? It was literally like on The Office when they start talking to the documentarians. That's what it felt like, but medical style. I'm like, am I being secretly recorded with like my boob just hanging out for the world to see? Like, what the heck is going on? So after they're done talking, I look at her, I'm like, who are you talking to? And they just bust up laughing. And are like, oh, we have to do that before every procedure. But the majority of time people are unconscious for that part. So I could see who you're wondering who the heck we are talking to. And the surgeon just thought it was the funniest thing ever. So you'll learn new things every day, my friends. Ended up being super fast. They used that fancy machine I showed you that kind of just looked like a big, it reminded me of those pumps you use for like at home IVIG. It looked like that. They shoved it in here and you could see through the scan, like the needle going through the tumor and just like sucking it up. Like it was really, really cool. They did that 3 times on the 3 different tumors. They only had to make 2 incisions, which was really nice because 2 of the tumors were really close together. And yeah, it was really, really easy. I mean, the second tumor was pretty painful. I'm not really sure why, but they listened really well and we were able to get the pain under control. And it also was really validating because the 3rd tumor was actually the one I felt, the one that made me call to schedule the scan I'd been putting off in the first place. So that was kind of a confirmation to me. Like I was talking to the nurse about this, especially as women, we're all too often to like put back our feelings, our emotions, our intuition and like second guess it. But that was just the proof I needed that you shouldn't ever second guess those feelings when it comes to your health. So especially this breast cancer awareness month, don't just go buy a pink shirt. Go get your scans, like do self-exams, know your breast health, know your family history, be on top of your scans and trust your intuition. Trust if you feel something, trust if you see something, trust if you feel like something's wrong. It's always better safe than sorry. I got all 3 of these done. She was the sweetest thing ever. I even ate some emotional support chocolate, even though I probably shouldn't have. And they're very, very cautious about keeping everything sorry. They're very cautious about keeping everything super sterile because of my CVID, which was really, really nice. And I didn't bleed out everywhere all over the place because that was my nightmare last night. Because as you know, my new chemo medication could completely destroy my blood counts. So we know at least my platelets are in good shape because I would have turned that room into a horror movie if they weren't. So I am going to go eat some barbecue, probably head over to the Minky store and then just relax. I am so glad that that biopsy went a lot better than expected. It's gonna be my new best friend for a few days, but hopefully the results should come back in 3 to 5 business days and let's hope for some good news. So little continuation of the vlog. Last night I got home and realized that my incision site had like bled through everything, which freaked me out because I have a platelet disorder and the chemo med can destroy your blood counts. So I'm just in my head, I'm like, crap, 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 crap. This is not good. And that nurse who I told you I loved yesterday, and I think we're technically best friends now, she gave me her personal number. And she told me, she's like, just text me if you have any problems. I'll be working all night in the emergency room anyway. And I didn't want to text her and bug her on her personal number, but it was bleeding. And I looked on the paper and it's like, if there is bleeding, contact your care provider immediately. So I sent her a text and I'm just going to show these to you because like, she is the sweetest person ever. She was texting me all night telling me like, how to stop the bleeding. Like, look at these texts. We, like, medical professionals get so much crap lately, especially during COVID, but this is the kind of stuff you need to see. In her, like, spare moments working in the ER, she took time to help me control my bleeding so I wasn't freaking out and things were, like, okay, you know? Because in my situation right now, a little extra bleeding is really scary, especially when it's not supposed to bleed. I've never had a biopsy site bleed before, but gratefully the bleeding did stop, as you see on the messages, and she was just the nicest person ever. Today has just been really chill and just been relaxing most of the day after telehealth appointment, and we're going to end this little vlog right here. I am so tired. I'm a bit stressed waiting for those biopsy results, I gotta admit, but I'm so grateful for really good people. It seems like that nurse, she was an answer to prayer. Every time I pray for peace, God sends really, really, really good people my way. So remember, God's hand is even in the littlest of details. If you're headed for a biopsy, please know that it will not be 3 hours long. And just have faith through whatever you're facing. You will get through this. Things will be okay. Stay strong and as always, smile on. And if you like this video, make sure to like, comment, share, subscribe, and follow me, The Life of Smile McGee, on Facebook, Instagram, YouTube, and TikTok. You can also find my writings on themighty.com under the name Megan Marjorie. Thank you guys again. Love you. Bye.